Moments ago, I spoke with Oklahoma's Republican Senator James Lankford. He is a member of the Senate Intelligence Committee, and I asked him about all of this.
This is the obvious reason why we need oversight over all of our intelligence operations, to be able to evaluate what's being done, how it's being done, what authorities are being used, and then what can be learned from that. So we have a lot of questions as well on any kind of wiretap that's used, especially on an American citizen. And we'll ask those questions, and we will get answers to those questions as we go through the next several months.
Does it strike you as odd that there could be FISA courts approving wiretaps of Paul Manafort that James Clapper, the director of national intelligence, had no awareness of?
Yeah, I'm trying to identify where that authority would come from. Obviously, with an American citizen, that's a very different animal to be able to go through a wiretap, especially in an intelligence operation. That is not allowed without a clear FISA court. For Jim Clapper to step in and say that he was not aware of it, and he could absolutely say no, he had never seen that, wasn't approved, didn't happen. We still have a lot of questions, and we will get answers.
Yeah, and a lot of people want to know what the basis for the FISA warrants was, what evidence it was based on that they were going to do those taps.
There's a very high standard, as you know, for FISA courts. That's not something that's done flippantly. That's a very strong group of judges. So if a FISA court is involved, there's been a very, very high standard. We're trying to find out, was a FISA court at all involved in that?
All right, Senator. I want to turn your attention now to Michael Cohen, an attorney for President Trump who was involved during the campaign. He was supposed to speak to you all on your committee today. What happened?
Well, he was supposed to speak to our committee privately. We have a lot of interviews that we do behind closed doors to be able to ask hard questions, that we go through the process, but we ask those witnesses not to be able to put out a big statement before or after. Obviously, we as the Intelligence Committee are not going to put out a counter statement. So it's best if they don't put out a statement that then we get questions about to say, did this get said? What else got said? Because we're going through the investigation trying to handle it in a professional way. Mr. Cohen wasn't honoring that, and so we pushed to have that committee not meet today, and then later made a request then to say, if he's going to make a statement publicly, then let's go ahead and make public statements, and we'll do the hearing in public. He's since agreed to do a public hearing on that, and we'll walk through those exact same questions with him.
Yeah. So he was supposed to sort of have this closed session with you all, answer questions. He put out a 4-page statement saying that he had no interactions with the Russian government. Ostensibly, that's what he said in the statement, I should say.
Right.
He and his lawyers, you know, were going back and forth in the room, sort of discussing what they were going to, you know, how they were, what their side of it was going to be presenting this. Did that frustrate all of you?
No, it's entirely reasonable for them to be able to talk about how they're going to handle it and what they're going to do. It's also entirely reasonable for us to get as many questions answered as we can. Again, the way the Senate Intelligence Committee is working in a bipartisan way. We've got bipartisan staff. We've got bipartisan cooperation that we're trying to get through and get to the facts. No one should be afraid of all the facts coming out. When the facts get out, then we get a chance to get this resolved, and the American people can move on from this. It's a distraction until we get it resolved. So we're trying to handle it as professional as we can to be able to walk through the process, because at the end of it, we're going to put out a full report and to get all the information out and all the questions that have been asked and what we have back.
What's your interest in Michael Cohen specifically?
Well, we have obviously all kinds of interest. I don't want to go into all the details of that and exactly what we're going to ask him, but many of the things you'll see now, because it'll be a public hearing now, and we'll ask him those questions that we were going to ask in private. We'll ask him now in public and walk through it then.
Do you have any indication that he's unhappy about the fact that this is now a public hearing?
No, he's agreed to it. Obviously, we had approached them early on from the committee and had asked him not to put anything publicly. He chose to do that, so we chose to then say, well, let's just put it all out publicly and testify then.
Big change in events as a result. Senator Lankford, thank you very much. Always good to see you, sir.